Welcome everyone to the annual meeting for the Arvada Chamber of Commerce. We're just going to give it a moment to allow everybody to hop on in, and we'll get started here in just a minute or two.
Things are very different now, but Arvada is a strong and resilient community. We know how to support each other and our economy, even when that means we support each other from our living rooms. We shop at our local stores. We dine on our favorite local food. We get creative to connect with our families and schools. We celebrate our superheroes. We care for and about each other because everything we need is all in Arvada.
Welcome everyone to our 2021 annual meeting and State of the Chamber. The video that we just showed you is part of our All in Arvada campaign that we did in December, and we think it's a great reflection of 2020 and how incredible our community was in coming together. I would love to give a big shout out to Mountain Media Productions and For the Win Communication for their participation in the All in Arvada campaign, which, as I said, was really indicative of how we tackled 2020. This time a year ago, the Chamber had big plans across all of our priority areas that we would shift or scrap altogether as March came about. We saw new and unique challenges as a Chamber and a community, but we leaned in. We leaned in completely, and we were all in to delivering innovative programs, resources, and policy shifts to benefit all of our Arvada businesses and nonprofits. Today, we'll be reviewing the learnings and successes of 2020 and our plans for 2021. We must start, though, by saying a big, big thank you. All of last year couldn't have happened without all of you that are listening in today, as well as the many community partners that supported us and each other. We thank you for your honesty, creativity, and kindness. We thank you for your continued commitment to be all in Arvada. It's a kind of a strange day for us at the Chamber. Normally right now we would be schlepping silent auction items over to the Arvada Center for our annual dinner. We know today is not the same. We are sad about that, but we hope that we can enjoy this opportunity to connect with each other and have a little fun. Those of you that have attended our annual dinner and our State of the Chamber before know that we like to do things a little differently here at the Chamber. We like to smile, we like to have fun, and so that is what we attempted to put in today. So we hope that you enjoy this next 45 minutes that we have together. I would like to ask a big favor of all of you though. We want this to be an engaging event, just like it would be if we were in person. So I will ask that starting out today that everybody jumps in that chat box and just introduces yourself. Name, company, maybe how long you've been a Chamber member. It'll be fun for us to see all of those amazing smiling faces that are on the other side of the screen. So if you can take a moment to introduce yourself in the chat, we really appreciate that. I would also like to take a moment to thank all of our sponsors. This is always a big piece of our annual dinner, is showing our incredible appreciation for the sponsors that have supported the Chamber throughout the year. On the screen, you can see the 2020 sponsors of the Arvada Chamber. I want to give a big shout out to Custom Environmental Services, the City of Arvada, Apex, Arvada Economic Development Association, PBS Wealth Management, Mankey Autobody, Super Credit Union, Alpha Graphics, First Bank, Family Tree, Lakeside Insurance, Jefferson Center for Mental Health, Icota Construction, Red Rocks Community College, Xfinity, Professional Construction Services, Steubens, Fairway Independent Mortgage, Adams County, and Lang Land Surveys. I am so incredibly grateful for the support of these sponsors. We can't do the work that we do as an organization without their steadfast commitment. So big thank you to all of you. I'd also like to take a moment to recognize the many elected officials who were able to join us today, which I'm sure you see their names popping up in the chat as well. We do have Mayor Mark Williams with us today. Thank you, Mayor. City Council members David Jones and Nancy Ford, Arvada City Manager Mark Devin, Senator Rachel Zinsinger, Representative Lindsay Doherty and Brianna Titone, and from Congressman Perlmutter's office, we have Ashley Verville with us today. Thank you all for joining us. I want to encourage you throughout today to keep those messages going in that chat box. We want to hear from you and see those comments and questions come up. Feel free to use the Q&A as well. If there's a question you have about the chamber or community, we'll do our best to get that answered for you today as well. So with that, we're going to start today with a little bit of the pomp and circumstance of our annual meeting. And it's my pleasure to turn things over to our chairman. A couple years ago, we introduced Jeremy at our annual dinner, which happened to be a Mardi Gras theme. Some of you might remember this. I don't know how long this is going to go on. All right. So we know that being the chairman of our organization is a huge professional growth opportunity. And boy, have we seen Jeremy grow and, quite frankly, age a bit over the past 2 years. There's been a lot of stress. So we recently captured this video of Jeremy dancing. Check it out. All right, we know that was silly and fun, but thank you, Jeremy, from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for your leadership of our chamber and growing with us professionally over the past few years. I will turn the floor to you.
Thanks, Cammie. Can't say I'm going to be upset to see the baby get retired. That's not necessarily a bad thing. But it has truly been an honor to serve as the chairman of the Arvada Chamber for both 2019 and 2020, and clearly a lot to reflect on from these last 2 years as we faced uncertainty and challenges as a community. As this is my final run and I guess task as the chairman of the board, I wanted to share a couple of reflections for the last few years in terms of where we've gone as an organization. As a board, we focused on organizational structure and getting clear on priorities and action that will mean driving meaningful change within our community. With a new vision of healthy businesses, thriving community, we worked to implement strategies that put our businesses in the driver's seat of community and business impact. Topics like building our talent pipeline, developing next level leaders, and tackling the increased costs of healthcare through the Arvada Healthcare Alliance were just some of the opportunities that we took on to serve as a catalyst for our Arvada businesses. We also approved a new mission statement. The Arvada Chamber of Commerce is the catalyst for solving Arvada's most critical business challenges and a champion for advancing a thriving community. As March of 2020 hit, we knew wholeheartedly that our work had to change and be focused on COVID-19 response and recovery. And our team truly rolled up their sleeves and quickly determined that what support businesses needed and went to action in partnership with other members of the Arvada Resiliency Task Force. The Chamber took on new roles in 2020, including public health advocate, grant administrator, PPE expert, and in many cases, a business therapist. There is certainly much to be proud of, but there's also concerns and challenges as we navigate through new and different times. The Chamber has been built on in-person meetings and gathering and had to quickly change and shift all of our strategies as of March. With the launch of the Arvada eChamber of Commerce, we quickly adapted to continue to serve our business community through webinars, puzzle nights, and hundreds of Zoom meetings. While we all recognize that this is far from ideal, we're pleased to say that we have seen thousands of people virtually this year. And I'd be remiss if I didn't note that the Chamber also had to completely revisit our financial model that was based on membership investments and event revenue. Both of these items had a substantial uncertainty. We're grateful for the opportunity to support local economic recovery through the CARES Act and partner grant funding. This allowed us to continue to do the work of the Chamber and focus on recovery and business resilience. I can say with complete confidence that these last couple of years have been memorable for all, And I'd like to take a moment to thank my fellow board members for their incredible engagement, leadership, and partnership. Every board member has contributed in impactful ways, and it makes a big difference in how the Arvada Chamber operates. I'd also like to take a moment to specifically thank and recognize our outgoing board member, Hazel Hartbarger. Many of you know Hazel and recognize her thoughtful leadership style and genuine love for this community. Her voice and presence will be missed, but we know that she is just a phone call away. Please join me in thanking Hazel for her commitment. Okay, so the moment has come for the virtual gavel pass. It's my pleasure to introduce you to your incoming 2021 and 2022 Chairman of the Arvada Chamber of Commerce. You may or may not know this about Larry, but he is not only a well-respected business and community leader, but also an avid Formula One racing fan. So we are kindly dubbing the next 2 years Chamber in the Fast Lane. I don't know why Larry's picture doesn't get music and dancing, but you know, so be it. Still a pretty solid picture. Please join me in welcoming your next chairman, Larry Barker. It is my pleasure to pass you the gavel, my friend.
Jeremy, thank you so much. I appreciate it. I'm looking forward to this opportunity. It is a great pleasure to sit in this chair. As I first got nominated, my friend Michael McCarran said, if you're going to keep up with Cammie and the Chamber team, you're going to need to have some form of superpowers. Well, bring it on, Wonder Woman, because I'm ready to help in any way that I can. Thank you, Jeremy, so much. If you can turn your camera back on for just 1 second, Jeremy. We deeply appreciate the contribution that you have made during your time as the chairman. It has been a complete pleasure to serve with you. Your kindness toward others, your true intent to serve, your desire to understand all of the elements and be great at what you do has been a blessing to every member of, especially the board of directors. And it's been a pleasure to serve with you, but also your service to every person who is within the chamber. We're there very, very thankful for you. Thank you, Jeremy. I just want to be clear about this. Cammie did not force me to actually call her Wonder Woman. I, as soon as she suggested it, wanted to do it myself. Let me just take a few minutes to talk about me and who I am. Hi, Cammie.
That's a big no, and I'm not supposed to be on camera right now, but I'm going to poo-poo that one right there.
I thought this was my part of the program. My name is Larry Barker, and I work at a well-known company here in Arvada, and that is Sancio. Before coming to Sancio, I served in many large corporations. Before coming here, I was the general manager for Otterbox, which grew about 2,000% over 6 years. That's about $50 million to $1 billion in a six-year period. Before doing that, I worked at a company called Clearwire, which created the LTE infrastructure that every cell phone carrier in the US uses. Before that, I worked at a small startup, which started with $14 billion in initial investment capital called Level 3 Communications, which is also headquartered here in Colorado, and has since then merged with CenturyLink. I am currently the Chief Operating Officer at Sancio. I have the immense pleasure of working with David Jones, who is our Chief Executive Officer. Sancio is a service provider in the automotive industry and is headquartered here in Arvada because Arvada is critically important to the Jones family and especially David Jones, who makes sure that we're serving our community as well as the businesses that we need to serve. I would like to take just a few minutes to explain why I am interested in the chamber and what I expect to do over the next 2 years. As I first got engaged with a chamber, I felt an immense sense of community, a support for individuals who were trying to run businesses in challenging environments. This last year has been even more of an opportunity to sense how great it is to live in a city and a community where everyone is pulling together to be successful. I am so thankful to have that around me and be a part of that. That is what made me desire to serve within this position. Everyone knows that Cammy is amazing and it's a pleasure to serve with him, with her. But most importantly, I am so thankful for the opportunity that I have to serve the community that loves me. I'd like to talk about just a few things today that are important to me and that I hope to focus on over the next few years. The first is thriving business. I think you saw a transformation last year in what we do within the chamber. We pivoted 180 degrees from what we normally do to make sure that our businesses were surviving and thriving. That is the heart of what we do in the chamber, and I'm thankful for the opportunity that I have to help serve in that capacity. I trust Cammy and the chamber team to guide us where we need to go in order to support what initiatives are important to the community that we live in. Having correct information about COVID, advocacy at the county and state level, leadership training that any business in the Arvada area can participate in are just a few of the ways in which a thriving business is critical to us. As we go through the next few years, we will also continue to focus on opportunities for people to serve within the leadership ranks of the Arvada Chamber. We have many opportunities on CAPS councils and the board of directors. And if you want to be engaged, we invite you to contact us and help make Arvada a thriving business as well as a thriving community. The second thing that I would like to focus on are the core things that we have been engaged in over the last several years, and that is a focus on outcomes. We are very, very focused on not just what activities we take, but what actions we deliver. We have 7 priority areas that we focus on, and those priority areas are critical to us, and we measure ourselves on our ability to actually deliver results in those areas. And the chamber team will talk to those 7 areas a little bit later. The next thing that I will be critical over the next few years is innovation. Innovation is the key of delivering, transforming, and being more effective. The chamber has historically been very good at innovation and creation. I hope to continue that core idea of being strategic in what we do and innovation in how we approach it. The last thing that I would like to ask for is for every member of the chamber to think about how we can help to grow the chamber health. It is important that we have a thriving and striving chamber in order to be an effective business community and support the community that we live in. I would invite each of you to think about our business models, how we're supporting you as an organization, and if there are better ways, please reach out to us. I would also invite you to bring your friends and associates who might not already be members of the chamber to come and join with us in the strength that we have in building businesses in Arvada. I would like to finally talk about, on the screen, we will display the 2021 Board of Directors and Executive Committee. Thank you. These are the individuals that I have served with over the last few years. It is an absolute pleasure to serve with them. I am thankful for the opportunity that I have to know them and work with them. And I would encourage you, if there are members of the Board of Directors that you do not know, please feel free to reach out to them. This is a very giving community, and you will be blessed by the opportunity to to actually interact with the members of the board of directors. I am very, very thankful for each of them and look forward in my coming years to the opportunity that I have to continue to serve with them and for the work that we will accomplish. It's now my pleasure to bring back the chamber president, Cami Welch, and our incredible chamber team. And just kidding about the Wonder Woman thing.
Mm-hmm. I'll remember that. Thank you. Thank you both, Larry and Jeremy. We appreciate both of your leadership as we navigated some uncertain times in the past, and we know the future is going to offer some new opportunities as well. So now is the part of the agenda where we're going to reflect a little bit on 2020. And I want to start by reflecting on the role that the Chamber staff played last year. So as was noted, we rebranded in March of last year to the Arvada eChamber of Commerce as we all moved to working from home and trying to figure out what that looks like. We thought it was important that we think about how we serve our community in the same way, but through that virtual platform. So our team took a moment to reflect and share a little bit with you about how our experience of working from home was. So we're going to invite all of you to share with us what your bright spot of 2020. I know there was a lot of heartache and difficult times last year, but we recognize that there were also some exciting things or new things that happened. These are just a few that we want you to try to associate with. So if you want to take a moment and respond to those, we'll share the results here in just a second. While you're thinking about those, I want to take a moment and sing the praises of my amazing chamber team. This year was difficult, and they stepped up in a big way and innovated and worked countless hours to support all of you and our business community holistically. So I want to just give a big shout out to the entire chamber team for their work this past year. So it looks like our poll is rolling in, and we are right now seeing the leader of the bright spots of 2020 being more time with family, which is a lovely thing. We'll give it about 30 more seconds. Oh, it looks like we finished the poll. Perfect. So the leader ended with more time with family. A close second here being new fashion opportunities and binge watching Netflix. So I hear we have some Tiger King fans out there, which I don't know if we should all be proud of or not. Awesome. Well, thank you guys for participating. We will have one more poll later. Again, we're looking for some major engagement through this session because it's lonely on this side of the webinar. So we appreciate you playing along. We're now going to move into Ryan talking about social media.
Thank you, Cami. I'm Ryan Hecht. I'm the marketing director here at the Arvada Chamber of Commerce. We wanted to look at our top 10 most engaging posts on social media in 2020. And you know, the big trend for 2020 was that you and the community really liked good news popping up on your social media feeds. So let's jump right into our first top two social media posts most liked were actually from our Chow for Champions initiative, which helped feed 800 essential workers and first responders during, you know, the COVID-19 pandemic. So big kudos to everyone who participated in this program, either in making contributions or the restaurants that provided the food, or anyone who shared about this initiative. We're really proud of the work that went into Chow for Champions. Up next, the Old Town street closures were a big news in 2020. Here we had two stories about the expanded patios and the impact to our businesses in Old Town with those expanded patios. You see Hunter Bay Coffee Roasters experienced a drop in business at the beginning of the pandemic, but then was able to seat 25% capacity in Old Town, which is huge news for a lot of other businesses in Old Town. We also had a lot of engagement, as you saw at the beginning of this presentation, with the All in Arvada campaign. Here we have the video that you saw at the beginning of the presentation that encouraged supporting our local businesses and nonprofits during the holiday season. So we really appreciate everyone engaging with that campaign and encouraging others to engage and support local. And then finally, big campaign for the Chamber and the Arvada Resiliency Task Force in 2020 was the Safe and Open campaign, in which over 270 businesses signed up to be safe according to guidance from the local counties to be safe while reopening. And we distributed posters that were hung up in windows, and throughout these social media posts, the community really loved to see which businesses were reopening and were safe opportunities for the community.
Thank you, Ryan. It's fun to recount what those posts were. 2020 felt like such a long year, and so it's great to see where things landed on the social media side. Thank you. I would also like to take a moment as we reflect on 2020 to really note the level of partnership that happened last year. And that is, for me, one of my bright spots of 2020 is the opportunity to work so closely with so many local partners to move the needle in such incredible ways. I want to give a big thank you to the City of Arvada, Arvada Economic Development Association, the Arvada Visitors Center, Old Town Bid, Apex, the Arvada Center, and all of the members of the Arvada Resiliency Task Force that came together and early on in the pandemic were meeting on a daily basis to understand what business needs were and how we could support each other. The success of 2020 for this community that we did see was because of the collective impact that happened through these partners. So we're incredibly grateful. The other thing I want to note that I think is really exciting was that last year brought an opportunity for more regionalism. And so we were able to connect not only with other chambers within the Jefferson County area, but with other economic development partners and the county government to really work together to support our businesses and community. And I think that the prospect of that going forward and how we can continue to work collectively is going to help all of us to be more successful long term. So I just want to give a big thank you to all of those partners who were part of this work in 2020. As Larry noted, one of the things that we've really been focused on as an organization is making sure that we don't just talk about what we do, but proving that there's outcomes to that work. And so we're committed to being a high impact organization that is really focused on driving positive change for our business community. And so as we talk about our priority areas, you'll hear us talking about what we expect to happen as we move forward into 2021. But we think it's really important to reflect as well, to think about what are those things that happened and what can we learn from them and what should we be proud of. We do have a little mini trailer here for you of what's included in our annual report, and then we will be dropping in the chat a link to the full annual report. It's a lot of information, but if you have the time, we highly encourage you to read it because it will give you a sense of pride for this community and what we've done together. Thank you. Awesome. So we'll drop that link in the chat box so you can take a peek at the full scope of inclusions in the annual report. So as we continue, we wanted to share a bit with you about some of the numbers from 2020. So Samantha, I'll kick it to you to talk about the data.
Hi, everyone. Like Cami said, we love our outcomes here at the Chamber, and especially when they involve numbers. And so you'll find a lot of numbers in our annual report that reflect some of the achievements of the past year. And so we wanted to just pull out our favorite numbers for you and share them today. So starting with number 10. We had 2,122 meetings conducted by Chamber staff. And I'm sure many of you here are a part of those. So thank you for that. And coming in at number 9, we handed out 26,450 disposable masks at our PPE distribution. At number 8, our website had 68,910 views, which was over double from 2019. At number 7, we fed 800 frontline workers through our Chow for Champions program. At number 6, we hosted 31 free community events, many of those around COVID-19 response. And number 5, there were 11,127 engagements on social media. So thank you to those of you who engage on our social media. And number 4, we had one ban on the words pivot, unprecedented, uncertain times, and abundance of caution. I'm sure you are all sick of hearing those words, and so are we. So one ban on those words. At number 3, we had 67 members featured in our Invest in Arvada publication. And number 2, there was a 3,000% increase in virtual events. Please don't check the math on that, but we're pretty sure that's what it was. And finally, coming in at number 1, drum roll please, 4,289 times saying you are on mute in those 2,000 meetings conducted by Chamber staff.
Awesome. Thank you, Sam. Appreciate your energy in sharing that. Lot to reflect on last year for sure, and certainly a lot of changes. So thank you. So we're going to turn the page and we're going to talk a little bit about 2021 and what you can expect. So as you've heard a couple times throughout this meeting today, you, our members, are at the heart of what we do as an organization. As we're looking to be a high impact organization, we recognize that it's all of your leadership that makes that happen. So we appreciate, as you have the capacity to engage with us, that you can do so in a meaningful way. So one of our big initiatives for 2021 is to be really clear about where there are seats at the table. And so we've spent a lot of time figuring our external engagement structure. We're going to share on the screen here our what we call external org chart for all of you to peek at. You're going to hear us talk in a moment about our various priority areas and how we think about those and talk about those. But what you see on the screen here is all of the opportunities to engage with our organization and therefore make our business community better in 2021. So you can see here that we have our board of directors that serves as an oversight council for our organization. They will be taking on topics this year like diversity, equity, and inclusion, thinking about strategies for the chamber long term. We'll also be excited to launch a legacy board for some of our past board members that are looking for new ways to engage at that level. Below them, you see we have priority caps councils. And I know many of you have heard me say this before, but if you are averse to bad words, you can earmuff it for a second. But we have our priority kick-ass problem solver councils. So basically, the moral of the story here at the Chamber is we're sick of committees, we're sick of advising. We want people that want to show up and roll up their sleeves and make a difference. And so if that speaks to you, we want to encourage you to think about a CAPS Council and how you can engage. And we have a CAPS Council that oversees workforce, leadership, advocacy, healthcare, networking, marketing, and resiliency. So if that's an area of interest for you, we'd love to have that conversation. Underneath those, we have various opportunities, one being action team. So oftentimes the topic comes up, for example, with our workforce, that we need to figure out how to better serve youth and finding careers. So we've developed a youth pipeline action team to support that specific initiative. And then we have what are called networks. A network is really an opportunity to come together with like-minded people and work together to make connections and support each other personally and professionally. Finally, we have convenings. Those are going to be things that happen on a one-time or just a limited basis and allow people to connect in a really strategic and meaningful way. So I paint that whole picture for you because it's really critical to us that we continue to think about who those leaders are that serve in our opportunity to help this be the strongest community in all of Colorado. So I want to encourage each of you to think a little bit about what that looks like and how you can engage in that as we move forward into 2021. I also want to take a moment to paint the picture of our commitment to being a pro-business voice. We really are focused not only through our advocacy lens and everything we do to making sure that the business voice is the leading charge in what we do. So being at the table and contributing to those conversations is how we do that effectively. So we appreciate all of you stepping up in a way that makes sense for your business as we move forward. So with that, we're going to talk a little bit about those priority areas and give you a sense of what you can expect from our various priorities in 2021. We're going to start with resilience and recovery, which is a priority area that was added to the chamber in 2020 in response to COVID-19. We had a lot of really exciting accomplishments within this, including the launch of a resilience boot camp. And we had nearly 30 businesses that completed that program and can say today that they're stronger because they have the education and knowledge to handle whatever situation comes at them going forward. You can see on the screen with each of these slides that are coming up the tactics and the vision of the work that we do within that space. But our commitment and what we're planning on for 2021 for you to know is we will be keeping a focus on the business pulse. And so you can expect that you're going to get surveys, flash polls, phone calls, really us being an active partner to you and reaching out and saying, well, how are you? What do you need? What's going on? And we're so grateful for your response to those because it really does help us to keep a pulse on what's going on and design programming and support businesses effectively. You heard me talk about pro-business advocacy. We're keeping a strong pulse on COVID-19 related advocacy efforts and how we can support you, whether that's funding or resource allocation. We want to make sure that you are at the forefront of that. And then we'll continue to share education and resources.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming. We are covering workforce now in 2021. We're really excited. Many of you are familiar with our VATA Works program that support our workforce initiative. So things you can expect this year. We are so excited about, you guessed it, data. The Chamber is working with so many partners on the development of a fully integrated data dashboard. This will be so critical for us to streamline our decision-making process in our workforce tactics. So really excited about that data. Also this year, we are implementing a platform technology called Seamless WBL, which stands for Work-Based Learning. This platform will link businesses with opportunities that they can supply for work-based learning. Schools will be involved, businesses, so it's a great connection point for both ends of the spectrum. It will be just an excellent tool for engagement across the board. And then finally, this year, a major focus will be on those partnerships, on aligning with businesses, suppliers, and organizations that support workforce and all of those strong tactics that need to come together and break down silos. So excited for all the workforce that we're doing this year.
I'm here to talk to you about networking. As you can see, networking is a big part of the chamber and what we do here and all of the tactics that go along with it. But overall, as far as networking goes, you can expect a mix of both in-person and virtual events this year. There'll also be more emphasis on relationship building than ever before. So we want to make those connections that are very useful to you and do that in a strategic way. And there'll also be a renewed effort to grow member engagement in all activities. So even when we're sitting behind our computer screens, we're going to find a way for everyone to be engaged and network with each other and meet new people and grow those connections more than ever before. And a big part of networking, of course, is our ribbon cutting events, which many people have attended over the years. And our favorite part about ribbon cuttings is just seeing the photos afterwards and the excitement that's just written over everyone's faces and the big smiles. So we pulled out the top five list here of in order of how of the ribbon cuttings that we had this year. So starting off, our number one here is a photo here. I think this is at Balefire's ribbon cutting. Mayor Mark Williams, look at that lovely smile. And then Sean Kaiser back there, just super pumped to be there. We love seeing these photos. And then next, I mean, this guy, I don't know his name, unfortunately, but this is at Nurgo's ribbon cutting. He is looking at those giant scissors like it is the most exciting thing he has ever seen. So that was definitely a fun photo there. And then here we are in the summer, and Holly, just you can just see that smile just all over her face. I'm pretty sure she's smiling. Her hands look happy. Oh, and this was at a Dream Dinner's ribbon cutting. This guy's, I think, excited. I think he's smiling there. And I think Douglas is back there. He's kind of covered up by that guy's hand, but we can just assume that he's smiling too. And our final photo, Councilwoman Lauren Simpson, she's got it down. She's smizing. She's smiling with her eyes. We know she's excited. But in all seriousness, just a big thank you to everyone who did attend our ribbon cuttings, even though it was definitely unusual at the latter half of this year. And we did love seeing your smiling eyes. And a big congrats to all the businesses who were able to open this year or move or celebrate a big anniversary. It's truly commendable that you were able to do that in such a difficult year.
Thank you, Sam. And we're going to add smizing to our you can use list because I love that word. That is amazing. Next up, as far as priority areas, is advocacy. Many of you are really engaged, and I'm super proud of our CAPS Council related to advocacy because they work really hard to understand during legislative session exactly what's coming down the pipe. But we're really excited in 2021 to continue to work on how we communicate to all of you. Policy changes matter, and we want to make sure that our business community has access to that information in a very timely fashion. So we've integrated some new marketing techniques to help you understand exactly what's happening from a policy standpoint. We're also going to be really focused on elected official engagement. So all of these fabulous elected officials that are on the call today, you can expect you'll be hearing from me more often, as well as the rest of our committee who are engaged in supporting our efforts in advocacy. So a lot of great things ahead with advocacy in 2021.
Hi there, me again to talk about leadership. This is our vision for leadership in the chamber and why it's so important and all of the various tactics that we have surrounding our leadership initiative. And what you're gonna expect this year is content. Content is king. And so whether that's finding the very best speakers for our boot camps or our business summit, and just producing this engaging content that that resonates with all of our attendees at events and various forums and boot camps and things like that. Also, what you can expect is a quarterly boot camp. So we're going to have our leadership boot camp as well as our business boot camp in all four quarters of the year. So we've just kicked off our leadership boot camp, which is going to be really exciting. And then we'll move to our business boot camp after that, and then we'll do it all again at the latter half of the year. And then secondly, I have a person joining me. Say hi to my son, Callan. And thirdly, AYP. Okay, hold on, buddy. I'm talking. Hold on, I'll be right with you. Thirdly, there'll be big changes to Arvada Young Professionals this year. So we're going to be really focused on community leadership's experiences in both the nonprofit and private sectors.
Awesome little 2020 moment there with Samantha. So again, I'm Ryan. I'm so excited to be covering the priority area of telling your story, which is just really exciting opportunity because I firmly believe that all of our members have a story to tell, a really exciting story to tell. And in 2020, that story was based really in the present as we were all kind of building the plane as we were flying it. In 2021, I hope to get back to sharing a little bit of the story of the past in the future as far as where our businesses and our members came from, and then you know, looking ahead to where you're going. And so we'll focus on more opportunities in that realm of written and video member spotlights. Video we really leaned into in a big way in 2020, and we'll continue that this year. As well, this year, we'll focus on opportunities for our members to be subject matter experts, and as on our blog, on our new content library that's just for members, Business IQ, as well as our new podcast, What's Important Now. Those are all opportunities for our members to get their voice out there. And lastly, on our new website, which we've just kind of relaunched, we'll have new member focus across all of those pages to help tell your story of how you're engaging with the chamber and the business community here in Arvada.
Thank you, Ryan. And the last priority, but certainly not the least, is our healthcare efforts. We launched in 2020 the Arvada Healthcare Alliance in an effort to improve access and lower cost of healthcare. Our signature partner for this to launch was Palladina Health, offering $99 direct primary care to our businesses per month. And it's a really great partnership. So as we move into 2021, we're eager to think about additional partners that can be added, specifically in the behavioral health space, vision and dental, to allow you to offer and engage in healthcare across your needs for your business. We also are looking at solutions related to catastrophic coverage. We know that that is a challenge for many businesses, and we're eager to continue those conversations. You can also expect that you'll hear a continued education for us on healthcare changes and what that means for your company as we move through 2021. So with that, we're going to do one more poll and then we're wrapping up for the day. And so we're going to stick this out here of what is, and I think we need to go to the next poll here. It looks like there we go. So we're looking for what your favorite priority area is within the chamber. So what are you most excited about for 2021? Networking, resilience and recovery, workforce, telling your story, advocacy, leadership, and healthcare. We'll give you just a couple seconds to complete that. And we'll share the results. Looks like we're a little bit mixed here, which is good. All right. Looks like the winner of the poll is networking is going to be what you're most excited about. I know we're all eager to get back together in person, with a close second being resilience and recovery, thinking about how we quickly respond and engage in moving forward. Close behind is telling your story and healthcare. So we will continue to make all of these areas priorities as we move forward, and we're eager to have all of you engage in that story. With that, we're so thankful to all of you for the time today and allowing us to update you on what's going on with your Arvada Chamber of Commerce. We consider it an honor to serve this community, and we are incredibly grateful for all of you and your participation. I will echo again, if you are looking to be more involved in the chamber or the community, we would love to have that conversation with you to help you in your efforts to be that true community leader. Thank you so much. We appreciate all of you. Happy 2021.